Hey guys!
Hey, welcome back to another episode of The Guerrero's Journey.
Yep.
So if you're new to this channel, just remember to hit the like, subscribe, and post notification bell. And leave a comment if you choose and everything. And so let's get to know each other. I'm Joe.
I'm Jennifer.
I'm Jacob.
And I'm Mary Jane. And so if you're new to our channel, we're a small family of four. And, well, we have three animals. four. But we travel around. And so we've lived in our RV full time for about
a year and a half.
Yeah, a year and a half. And then we've been traveling for 5 months already. And so during our time of traveling, as you guys have seen by previous videos, we've like been all over the East Coast of Maine. Or sorry, the Route 1. But we've been traveling that three times, and so we've been awesome because we got to see so many things, and that's what we love to record and share with you guys. And so yeah, that's a little bit. And so we actually hold Truth Ministries, which is our ministry.
It's been an amazing journey. Just full-time RVing alone has been
a journey
yeah, in really itself. Crazy. But then when we added in the ministry with it and actually traveling full-time RVing, that has been a extreme experience in itself, and it's been awesome. And so we want to share that with you guys. And so
try to share as much as all the cool stuff we see, and because we meet so many people in a day and we get to pray with so many people. That's the most awesome thing about it, is because we get to see God move like all the time through people.
And this is our home.
I mean, you see where we're at right now.
We're at a nice area and stuff in Maine.
To kind of catch you up, for those of you that have been following us, we had been going to New England, so we did go all the way down to New Hampshire and to Boston.
Yeah. Which it was
and
cool.
there was a lot of amazing things that happened there.
Yeah, even through Boston, through Fitchburg. But yeah, there was I had a lot of chances to pray with a lot of people, see a lot more resistance, a lot more negativity and stuff, and just in the bigger cities and stuff like
definitely
that.
Definitely saw bondages.
Yeah, definitely saw bondages and stuff, but definitely got to see just God working. And as we're down there, it's funny how, what we did in New England, we're down there praying with so many people, and we held signs and stood out so much, where now, as of last night, we just, at this Walmart in Thomaston, Maine, we came, we were drawn back to come back to Maine. And as soon as last night we were in Thomaston, Maine, ran into a couple who were, they've been traveling themselves and stuff, and they've been traveling a long distance, from Montana
to here
and stuff, and they got to see a lot of the stuff that's been happening.
Some of the riots and some of the horrible things that are going on.
And so they were, they would say, they were scared, because things are happening. So they had this fear. So God gave us this opportunity to pray with them and just to encourage them, just to bless them and stuff, And so it's amazing how God worked. And they said, the funny thing is how they told us that, he goes, we saw you guys. He goes, we thought you guys were just a bunch of hippies or somebody. He goes, we saw your convoy, you guys, throughout the route and everything, all these different places. We saw you guys, another bus like you guys several times.
In different states.
I said, well, that was us. He goes, we're just the same traveling ministry. It's just us four. But it was awesome because they said, they even tried to come up to us at one time where I guess we might have been out away from our RV at one time. Or something, I don't know, but it was amazing to actually just to see how people just saw us in this journey and everything.
So it shows, because and then they said they realized that we weren't hippies and that we were actually like sporting God. And so when they said that, they were like, we just have to talk to them. And so it was crazy that they weren't able to get to us the first time, but then God crossed our paths again all the way back in Maine. And it was just God's divine timing and appointment. So it was that was super cool.
And through the whole route, so much has happened with the ministry, like good things, and like it's been awesome to see how amazing the ministry is flourishing, thanks to God.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, and that's kind of some of the stuff that we've been doing, and things that are going on in the ministry.
So we like what we do is we love taking the church to the people. You know, we go out there, we pray with the homeless people. We get the chance to bless them with food. We're cooking a meal, help them out that way, waters or whatever it is. And at this time, we've actually got a chance to see a lot of the needs. You know, the more needs that the homeless is needing. And I remember last year, you know, that was last winter. We had a clothing drive for clothing for the winter drive for the homeless and people in need. And right now there is a need that we're doing, because we're actually starting to take donations and stuff like that for
small donations. As you guys, being full-time RVers, we don't have a lot of space, but what we do like to do is always try to have extra blankets and coats and hats. Things that we've noticed that they really need out there, because it is frigid cold out there, and they just don't have anything else, you know. And so those are some of the things that we're kind of trying to collect. So if you see us out and about and you have any of these items, like I said, we can't take bags, you know, upon bags of donations, but we can take some so that we are able to distribute them along the way. Because we definitely like to do hygiene packets for them, and we always try to do little food bags for them and stuff like that. Things that are just kind of nice, and they know that, you know, God's watching out for them, and that's also our opportunity to pray with them and give them Bibles and
tracts.
Yeah, because there is a whole nother lifestyle out there. Since we've been traveling this whole the New England area, everybody there where we've been to, we've noticed that there's not just homelessness, you know, people on the streets, but there's so many people living in their cars. Like, we've seen families, a lot of families living out of the vehicles because they lost their homes because due to COVID and all this other stuff, like more RVs and everything. So we run into all kinds of walks of life. You're not just, you know, going from, you know, like town to town, but Walmart to Walmart or Lowe's. So anywhere we go, where we decide to park for the night, you know, we always have someone that needs something, or they're scared, or something's going on in their life maybe they need prayer for. So we love how God's been using us to bless them as well and everything, and it's been awesome.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And everything.
Yeah.
So.
Absolutely, because it's been phenomenal just seeing how God's needed us to be obedient, and no matter what, it's very important. That's something that, you know, it's a challenge sometimes, you know, when we don't have to give, but then we always have prayer. We always tell them about God.
So. And if you see us out and about, please come up, and we love to pray for people. Yeah, we love praying for people.
And talking to you. If you guys have questions or just want to meet us or anything, we would love to talk to you. We'd love to meet you guys.
We're looking to get I want to get a little mailbox put on the outside of this.
Yeah.
And a doorbell and everything. So people do come and, you know, like we can't hear, we're cooking or whatever. Yes. At least, you know, they can put like a prayer box outside where people can actually, you know, pray, put, you know, some prayer requests. So if you see us out and about and you see this little box and everything, you can just definitely put a prayer request in there. Or if you see it on the door, slide it in the door, it doesn't matter. We'll get it and everything. And so we want to tell you what we're doing next, and, you know, what's been going on with Truth Ministries. And so we want to get started as we met this. I'll let you explain a little bit about it.
So we've been meeting with them and talking with them over video calls and messaging, and they have a phenomenal ministry already going over in Pakistan. Yes. As a lot of people know, that is an Islamic country, so it's very dangerous for them, and it's very hard for them to do this, but they're doing it, and God is just all over it. The Holy Spirit is leading them, and it's phenomenal. They have huge Sunday services.
Very led by the Holy Spirit.
Yes, 150 to 200 people gathering that in one building.
They feed orphanages. That him and his wife, they
do a lot of voluntary work.
Lots of going to the hospitals and praying and just doing all sorts of things. Well, they've been following us as well, and they actually reached out to us, and so we're going to join with them and expand Truth Ministries over to Pakistan, and it's going to be phenomenal, because they're going to use some of our teachings and some of our videos, and we're just going to see where God leads that. It's so exciting and phenomenal just to see how God's word is being spread. That's the whole purpose of what we do. And that kind of brings me into our next thing we want to talk about, is why do we do what we do? why do we feel that it is so important to do what we're doing? Because this is a very different lifestyle, out of the box, and it's not easy. And there's been a lot of trials and a lot of hardships through it. But through the whole thing, we see how the Holy Spirit leads. He teaches, He guides us. I mean, God has been all over it from the very beginning. From, yes. I mean, and we, that can go back to from when we were kids, you know, but we're talking about just the journey of right now. Just how God's been molding us and growing us and teaching us and really showing us the vision of what He needs us to be doing. And it's really just showing all about Jesus, yeah. All about God. Because the fact of the matter is that a lot of people push this aside like it's not important, but there is an urgency to it, and that's kind of what we want to let people know. Jesus loves you, mm-hmm. and there's definitely consequences if you don't pay attention. And, you know, it's all out of love. Sometimes, you know, we're very passionate about it. Through this, to understand the whole spreading of God's love and his actual truth, why did we do that? Because God showed us the fear of God and the actual fear of God.
Yes.
When we realized what the true fear of God was, not having him in our lives, really understanding that not having him for eternity and where you go to hell, that really, and what, just to not have him here with you and being far away from him, it's the fear of the Lord that keeps us focused,
yeah.
And it keeps us, you know, because with that, the love that he shows, the forgiveness that he's shown in our lives, that's why we do what we do here at Truth Ministries. God wants his word to be spread, and he just wants people to know how much he loves them and how much he's trying to reach out to each and every,
yes.
every one of you. And it doesn't matter where you're at, what you're doing, what sin you're caught in, what you're bound by, Jesus can save you. Jesus can break it. Jesus
Amen.
Heals.
Amen.
Jesus loves you. He's the answer to all of your problems, all of your circumstances. He's it, guys. I from past experience, just on my own, I know from experience, nothing else is going to fulfill that need.
That's right.
That you're seeking and wanting.
Yes. And so remember, like, no matter what situation you're caught in, you know, like, there's always, God's always, he's never going to leave you, never going to forsake you, you know. God says, you know, just seek upon him, you know, seek first the kingdom of God and all things will be added to you. See, that was a struggle for us, you know, like, I didn't want to give up a lot of things for myself, but when I did, and we started seeing God work in our family, you know, there's no turning back, so.
That's right.
You know, we want to let you guys know that everything that we're doing, it's, you know, it's to glorify God. It's not for our selfish gain or ambitions or anything like that. And everything, you know, the donations, if you see us out and about, please feel free drop in, you know, give us a talk, you know, shout. We'll definitely show you. You can check us out on Truth Ministries, www.truthministries.live, or check out our YouTube channel, The Guerrero's Journey, or our Facebook, Truth Ministries.
Truth Ministries, The Guerrero's Journey.
Yeah. And so, yeah. And you can see some other past videos we had and everything. And so, yeah, we're just out there just living for the truth, and we're standing for the truth in Jesus, you know, everything, and for God's gospel, and making sure that everybody gets a chance to hear it, and to be an encouragement for those that need that encouragement from anything. Our lives ourselves, people say, you know, that we are homeless, but, you know, this is our home. God blesses the home. He blesses with food.
Right.
God's always provided for us and everything. And, yeah, it's never going to be easy. Our lives are never going
to
be easy, but I can tell you what.
But we have
with,
to
but,
well,
yeah. Amen. Amen. Because God's got us taken care of.
Yeah.
See, God's got us taken care of. It's just, you know, like
trusting in him and having that faith. And that's,
yep.
It's awesome, because when we do this, it makes us seek him, want to seek him so much more. Just, it's so exciting. And it's being able to, like, my favorite part about it is always getting to help others, because God says to love one another. And ultimately, over all the Ten Commandments, if you just love, then love covers everything, because you're not going to want to hurt anyone, you're not going to want to, you don't want to break any of the other Ten Commandments. And so that's what just drives us, is God's love. And so we want to go out and distribute that and show it to everyone, because love can cover a multitude of sin. And right now, in the day of time we need, that's what people need. They need to know they're forgiven and God wants them, but wake up, you know, people need to just just know that God is real, you know. They don't take it serious. We're not promised tomorrow, and people tend to forget that. Sometimes we forget to do that. So also another good tip, just never go to bed angry at anyone, okay? You don't ever want to do that, because again, we're not promised.
Your time's up.
Exactly. But
so just remember, you know, that if you ever see us out and about, say hello, be sure to, you know, and all the time, just always remember, stand for the truth, stand for Jesus.
Before we leave, though, guys, we want to show you some awesome pictures of and introduce you guys to who Kashi Khan is.
Yeah. And the ministry that will be taking place in Pakistan. Yes.
So right now, as you, we're going to give you this a slide. So right now you're seeing Kashi Khan, and right now
Hey everyone.
Hey guys.
God
has been also showing us, in addition to what we're already doing out in, when we stop everywhere and hold signs and do things like that, we're going to start doing stuff out in the parks. I know it's getting cold here in Maine, but it's going to be a wonderful time. We're going to start sharing a word and doing communion.
And hopefully at Christmas time, we're going to be planning on wanting to do caroling. So as many of you know, last year we did caroling in a neighborhood, and it just was so awesome. And it brought brought the joy of the Lord to everyone, and it was just so awesome. So if you would love to help carol with us, that would be so awesome.
We plan on doing like a whole little service put together in the park from now on also, as weather permits and as we are able to. So it's going to be an amazing time. So when we do that, we'll let you guys know what area we're in and when we're doing it, and I hope to see you guys there.
Yep.
God bless you.
God bless you.